Now that we've learned about the theory of artificial intelligence and machine learning, what about the practice? How is machine learning used in detection services, and how well are companies prepared to respond to cyber attacks? Let's dive deeper. So what does your job include here at the Finnish Regulatory Communication Authority?
Specifically, the role of us is to try to ensure that the internet in Finland is safe for everyone. So as a company, you can think that, okay, this is a safe place to invest. This is a safe place to be when I know that certain basic things are handled for you.
What do you see are the biggest challenges when it comes to cybersecurity?
Well, basically, the detection of the new kinds of threats is a thing. So basically, you see this in the industry when new detection mechanisms are constantly popping up, and new kinds of ideas on how to protect the worst threat of current day are being developed, when the basic things that you should be doing are still remaining the same. Basically, make sure that your systems are up to date, patch the systems, make sure that the users don't have any more rights than they should have. So basically, identity access management. And then after that, when you've done the basics, then you need to have at least some sorts of detection.
How well do you think companies are equipped for these kinds of threats?
It varies a lot. So some companies are very well versed in this, and they've seen the kinds of things that are out to get them. So basically, these companies have already invested in protection mechanisms and invested in making their systems better and more resilient. Some companies have just started business on the internet.
This thing, the internet.
Yeah, and they might have not noticed yet that it's not a friendly, cuddly place, but when you're on the internet, you are a target. And well, those are the kinds of companies we are worried about.
So what, in your opinion, is the most difficult thing when it comes to threat detection?
Something which is difficult in current scenario, the way threat landscape is moving, is really to find out the bad behavior out of the good ones. So as a solution, we collect a lot of events from the actual machines, and not all of them are bad. So we really have to find out what exactly is out of ordinary there.
Is this also where the machines help, AI and machine learning?
Of course, that's the building block of our solution, that we really have to find needle in a haystack where we have so many events which we collect every day from every machine that we have our product installed in. So really working and finding bad behavior out of that good behavior is where our AI and our machine learning comes into picture.
What are the new threats that it's answering to?
So the threats are not new in that way, that they existed already. We have already endpoint protection solution in our portfolio, and that covers exactly like 99.9% of the threat scenario that we have. So the point detections, malware detections, and ransomware and whatnot. But then there is still this 0.1% of the real fileless attacks where there is no file or no malware involved. So not detecting that is not an option anymore. A login is a login, but a login done by someone who has bad intentions, and finding that out from a normal user's login is what the endpoint detection solution does. That it not only detects that there is a bad login, but it detects that what that login does after being there.
What are the key questions the CEO should be thinking about when it comes to preventing threats?
Well, I think a key question is, if we were hacked, would I have any way of knowing that? And when we are hacked eventually at some point, how much will it cost me, and how much should we invest in trying to prevent that from happening as much as possible?
In any crisis, what is important is to have a plan and practice it. Companies have long-term plans, they have strategic plans, they have even evacuation plans. So why not a cybersecurity plan?